Hello, and welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes from MAKERDEMY. And I'm Venkatesh, the founder of MAKERDEMY. In this episode, we will learn about wireless sensor networks and why they are often an important part of an IoT solution. When we want to rapidly prototype IoT solutions, we often use Raspberry Pi, the ESP32, or even the Arduino. This is all fine for prototyping, but a real-world deployment is a different ballgame altogether. In the real world, there are a variety of constraints. We have constrained networks, we have cost constraints, we may have to make our solution work in harsh environments, and so on. For example, let us consider a smart city project. Such a project may involve deploying several thousands of sensors all over a city, spanning an area of several hundred square kilometers. Often, these sensors will have to run on batteries with minimal or zero human assistance. Furthermore, the radio network may have bandwidth and quality constraints, and the project will also most likely have budget constraints. This is where the wireless sensor networks come into play. A wireless sensor network comprises of a large number of sensor nodes arranged in a variety of topographical configurations like the star, ring, and mesh. These sensor nodes are usually battery or solar operated and are designed to operate on very little power. Often, the radio transmission range of these sensor nodes is a few tens of meters, so the network nodes will have to relay the data from sensors all the way to the gateway, from where the data can be sent to the cloud via either wired Ethernet, cellular, or Wi-Fi networks. Thus, the data in a wireless sensor network takes a multi-hop path to reach the sync node or the base station. And what are the benefits of having this sensor network wireless? Well, to start with, it is a lot cheaper to build a wireless network rather than having a wired sensor network. Secondly, with wireless, the sensor network can be configured and reconfigured into various topographies like mesh, star, etc. very easily. Sensor nodes can also be added to and removed from a wireless network a lot easier than a wired network. Now, let us see what are the components of a typical wireless sensor node. The sensor is just one component of a wireless sensor node. Usually, it also has a power supply, a microcontroller, and a radio transceiver. Put simply, all this data from various sensors in the wireless sensor network take a multi-hop route to the base station or gateway, from where the data is funneled to the cloud IoT platform like AWS IoT, where all this data is cleaned and analyzed to come with actionable insights. Typical sensor nodes are used to measure temperature, humidity, vibration, light, heat, movement, moisture, and so on. That is all from me in this video, folks. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so that you get notified when new videos are released.